Let me tell you a story about Nick and Barry. Couple guys talking Raptors on Comedy Records. Talking about a team that just a few years back were the champions of the world. Nick and Barry talking Raptors on Comedy Records. Nick and Barry talking Raptors on Comedy Records.
Hey there. Welcome to episode 2 of season 12 of Talking Raptors. Barry Taylor here with Nick Reynoldson. What's going on, man?
Doing good, buddy. Doing good. We're in full swing right now.
2 weeks in a row. We're consistent already.
Look at us go.
Happy Halloween. Are you a Halloween guy at all?
No, absolutely not.
No, I'm not a big... not a big Halloween guy either. Wasn't really as a kid either. I mean, obviously for the candy, of course, but do you go to any parties or anything this year?
No, absolutely. Absolutely not. No, I don't want to bother with a costume. I don't.
No.
Not into drinking with people wearing masks.
It's a lot of effort, you know, for something that, what are we doing here? You know?
Yeah. I mean, like I do like seeing cool costumes.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm not going to make one. That's insane.
Right. You can appreciate Halloween from afar on my phone. You know?
Watch a horror movie at home.
Hey, speaking of which, I don't think we've done a podcast since you were Thanksgiving came out, did we?
I'm sure we didn't.
If you're surfing, I believe it's on Crave. I'm not sure. But Eli Roth's Thanksgiving features the one and only Nick Reynoldson taking a hell of a death, by the way.
Hell of a death, yeah.
Great. It's in the early parts too, but that said, watch the rest of the movie because there are some very good deaths in that movie.
Yeah, the movie itself is not the best, but my god, it's there's some good deaths in it for sure.
Hang on now, thing one,
what an opening week to the season. Opening night against Cleveland was kind of as expected, maybe a bit rougher than mm-hmm. anticipated. The 30 point loss is it's pretty big.
Honestly, it's a scary way to start the season, Barry.
Shout out to Cleveland, though. They're mm-hmm. cooking to start the regular season. So good for them. As predicted on last week's podcast, they're going to have a great regular season. Once it comes to playoffs, we shall see. Then, of course, we took on the Minnesota Timberwolves. That was, the Philadelphia game was before that, where mm-hmm. we smoked Nick Nurse and the Philadelphia 76ers. I hate that team more than anything, and seeing them win. Or seeing us win against them is always glorious.
It's always good, despite the fact that they're missing their two best players. We will take a goddamn win when we can get a win, man. Especially over Nick Nurse.
Absolutely. The Minnesota game, look, man, Minnesota's good. The fact that we kept it close at some points was a win for me, you know?
Yeah. I honestly think this entire season is going to be play hard for the whole game. That's a win. Mm-hmm. Just play hard, man. Don't give up. Play hard. Play with heart, hustle, all that bullshit. All those bullshit things you got to tell young players. But Anthony Edwards is disgusting, man.
Anthony Edwards is one of my – I think he's most people's favorite players right now just because he's so fun to watch, but then he's amazing off the court. Did you see him when Knick fans asked him if he's going to come to New York? And he's like, why? So you can boo me as soon as I have an off game?
That's amazing. Like, I did not see that.
Fucking right, Anthony. But then the game, even though it was a loss, that was the most fun, was Monday night against the Denver Nuggets. Oh, that was a lot of fun.
Ended in heartbreak, but that's going to be this year, man.
A few free throws made, a few less turnovers, and the team's 2-2. But what are you going to do? You know, Jamal Murray all of a sudden played like Jamal Murray again mm-hmm. the last 2 minutes in overtime. So that was nice for him, I guess. But really enjoyed watching that game, though. Was really into it. Screamed at the TV.
Yeah, I was fired up with that game. Scotty's dead, so that's it's good.
Right. Yeah. Just announced prior to recording of this podcast that he will not make the trip to Charlotte with the team. So, you know, that's not good. But
goddamn Jokic.
This is definitely on me, but when that first happened, I was like, he just nudged him. That wasn't bad. Thing, you know, I didn't think he looked bad at all.
Didn't think he looked bad either, but I guess that man is so big that forearm is gonna fucking hurt no matter you know how it looks on TV.
Does make a lot of sense. Everyone knows this, but he I think is still the best player in the league because he can just do whatever he wants. Like that entire game, He looked like he was just doing whatever he wanted.
Yeah, he's a basketball genius. It's crazy. It's
fucking awesome. And I didn't think Poeltl had that bad a game.
He played good. I know I told you I hated him. He played phenomenal. I hate him because I'm like, it's a brand new team. And then every time I see Yak, I'm like, man, this is not a new team. I know this guy. God damn it, man.
Right.
Does that make sense? I don't know. It just feels like everything is brand new, a fresh start, and then fucking this lumbering idiot.
Yeah, it's like you got a brand new outfit, but you're wearing old shoes.
Yeah.
Fuck this.
Old socks.
Yes, socks. Yeah, let's not give him shoes. Socks is more.
He's got holes in my socks, but the rest of me looks good.
He looked like a good pair of socks last night, though.
He really did.
Even there are a few times, obviously, the Joker cooked him, but it's like, yeah, he's, with no hyperbole, the best basketball player on the planet. Like, that's going to happen.
You know? Yeah, you're going to get cooked. Everyone's going to get cooked by that guy. Just don't get constantly cooked. That's what we want. And he didn't. He played really good, man. That was his best game he played this year so far.
Big fan of that. Speaking of having sort of the, association burn in your memory, every time I see Aaron Gordon, every time we play him, all I can think of is Kyle Lowry just taking the guy's manhood away and almost kicking the shit out of him.
Yeah.
You know?
Scottie Barnes called him a bitch too, which is fantastic.
Which is crazy too, because he was half of the greatest dunk competition maybe ever that happened right here in Toronto.
Mm-hmm.
Still wiped off my memory. Picturing Kyle Lowry telling him to meet him in the hallway. So
meet him at his hotel room. He gave him the hotel room number.
That's right. Yeah. So
that's what Aaron Gordon does. He starts fights with people just to get called a bitch. That's what happens. Almost every player in the goddamn league has called him a bitch. So
that said, he's pretty important to that team. He got his contract extension. So, he's a rich bitch. That's what it's come down to.
I mean, he can play a little bit of basketball sometimes. Hey,
would I take him on my team if we were contenders? Sure.
Yeah.
Right.
Oh yeah.
But would I take him in a fight against Kyle Lowry? No, I wouldn't. Despite the size discrepancy, I'm still taking the pit bull,
Yeah, 100%.
Which, ironically, I don't know if it was a pit bull that bit his face. It was his own dog. It was a pet dog.
And his own dog thought he was a bitch.
Yeah. Well, there's so many layers there.
Oh, yeah.
Using the bitch and then, I think it was a Rottweiler. Anyway, thankfully he's okay from that, but I think the Kyle Lowry branding is never going to escape that man.
Mm-hmm.
So that's something. All in all, a 1-3 week, very close to a 2-2 week, which with this start going against Minnesota, Philadelphia, Denver, and Cleveland was not anticipating. So I feel like we're already champions,
Yeah, that's plan the parade, man. Let's go.
Yeah, we can shut it down. I was losing my goddamn mind during the Denver game. Like at one point, I think we were up 15 or something.
Yeah.
Dude, and our rookies are good.
Yeah, they're good because they're not real rookies. They're rookies, but they're
40-year-old.
All these motherfuckers are 33 years old. So.
Yeah, but dude, it's like that. There was just a lot of hope watching the Denver game where you're like, whoa, maybe we are going to win again in the future. This is the beginning of the bench mob. And Shed is our next Fred VanVleet,
I mean, for God's sakes, Emmanuel Quickley hasn't played yet. Our starting point guard hasn't played a game yet. So,
dude, how good did RJ look as well? One dunk. That's the one thing I've noticed. It's a pretty consistent thing. But coming out of timeouts, they just call a play where he just gets the ball handed off and just flies in on the left. And that's where he got that one poster dunk, which, by the way, also over Aaron Gordon.
Mm-hmm.
Man, so glad to have that guy back. I freaking love that guy.
I don't think we're going to be as bad as people think, man. I think when everyone gets back, if we stay healthy, I think we're going to surprise a lot of people. Jack was talking about that on a broadcast yesterday. It's just basically like we're going to be very fun to watch. And I 100% agree with that.
That's all I care about, to be honest. Those are literally my expectations. I'm like, just entertain me, guys. Like,
yeah. Literally, just play hard and don't be embarrassing.
And that's been everything's looked like that more or less for the first four games.
Yeah, I mean, keep these, like, Scotty has some real, real bad turnovers, man.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, real bad ones. Like,
and, like several. Like, oh, not,
in a row,
like,
too, yeah.
Too many, like, way too many.
Yeah, yeah. He's throwing passes to Yak like he's going to catch him, and he won't. He can't. No, he does not have the dexterity to do that, but.
Yeah, yeah. He's looked really good in a lot of other places, so.
Oh, yeah, man. That kid. I mean, even Jokic had high praise for him after the game, too.
That's good.
He's a really good player. Knows what he's doing. Hey, man. One day, buddy.
Looking forward to it. Can't wait.
Yeah.
But it definitely, especially watching the Denver game, I was like, whoa, there's some hope right now. I feel like there's potential here.
Barry, all we're asking is that we don't have to start reviewing food at some point during the season. That's all we want. We want to get through the season just talking about the Raptors, not eating fucking rotis. And
that's the dream.
Samosas, God knows what we're going to get into.
I think we'd be left with shawarmas is all we've got left, really.
Yeah.
Which, again, I'm not opposed to.
No, I'm not opposed to anything I just said. I would love it.
Do you think, here's something, are you of the belief that Toronto has a better shawarma scene or Montreal?
Oh, Jesus.
Yeah. Yeah.
I mean, Montreal, I just get Boustan's, to be honest. That's my go-to.
Okay.
I've tried much more in Toronto.
Okay. Big Lebanese community in Montreal, though. So you just got
to... Big time. Oh, yeah. Shout out to all the Lebanese people that always come see me at the Comedy Nest. They are out there.
They got stuff locked down out there.
You know? Yeah. Ottawa has good shawarma, too.
Really?
Yeah.
Didn't see that coming. Okay. Uh-huh. Maybe it's just a spillover from Montreal.
I'm sure it is.
I agree. I haven't had enough of the... I'll say I haven't had a diversity of Montreal shawarma, but the shawarma that I have had there are consistently top tier. Mm-hmm. That's why the only reason I think they might give Toronto a run. You know?
Yeah. Yeah.
Anyway, look, we're a 10-game losing streak away from finding this out truly.
We'll go to Montreal if the season gets that bad. We'll figure it out, buddy. We'll hit Ottawa.
We can relocate the podcast. That's not above that.
Not a problem at all, buddy.
Not at all. But in the meantime, we're 1-3, almost 2-2. So
almost 2-2, buddy.
Feeling great.
How many things? Two? We got two. Thing two.
What is coming up? A couple big games. Obviously, none bigger than Saturday night's contest. But first, Wednesday, that is tonight, Devil's Night. Hey, I forgot about Devil's Night. You go out egging at all?
No. Are you crazy? My mom is Guyanese. Beat the shit out of me if I got caught egging someone's house.
Good for her, as she should. I did that a lot when I was a kid, which is embarrassing. And yeah, so.
I did put a potato in an exhaust pipe of a man we hated on the street. Yeah, I don't think it's... did anything, but
no, I mean, that sounds worse than egging to me.
Yeah, I mean, I saw the car and he was alive, so
okay,
nothing died, so
fair enough. So for Devil's Night, we're in Charlotte taking on the Hornets without Scotty Barnes, as mentioned earlier. That I feel like we're taking that game either way, though, right? That's going to be a big, let's go RJ Barrett game. I feel,
yeah, that could be a big Grady Dick game, man.
Didn't even mention him in thing one. He's looked awesome.
He has looked awesome, and I am really leaning into getting a Dick jersey.
That's the jersey, eh?
Oh my god! Can we? Sorry, this is gonna happen forever. I guess as long as Grady's on the team, which I hope he's a lifetime Raptor. But Matt Devlin said, "Battle in for Dick," and I was like, "Good God, man, this is nuts! Battle in for Dick." Holy smokes, man.
It doesn't matter how old you get. That's always going to be fun.
Oh, it's too good. I'm sure he giggled, too. He's like, I just said battle in for Dick.
Nice. They were showing a lot of people with the purple jerseys at the last couple games, and his and RJ seem to be the most popular right now, which makes sense, you know?
Yeah, I mean, hell yeah, dude. I can't wait to. I might buy one on Saturday, buddy, at the game. I might buy a purple jersey on Saturday.
Holy Toledo. Well, Friday, the James. Keeping up with the James. They're in town. Lakers take it on the wraps at Scotia. And then Saturday, is the Vince jersey retirement in front of DeMar DeRozan. Purple jerseys. A lot of purple that night with the Kings there. Does DeRozan get his jersey retired at some point?
Yeah, because he's going to cry if we don't do it. So we should put it up there just to make the man not talk about Masai Ujiri for fucking the rest of his life. So,
well, you know what? Tell him to retire in Sacramento. He can put up a...
Put it up to the Spurs, buddy. Chicago. Fire it up there.
He can crip walk to that podium. How about that?
Good God.
That'll be fun, though. That's going to be our first game of the year. The Kings and the Vince retirement. Very unsure how we're going
to try to keep you calm, buddy.
You know what's going to be a big factor is if we go for wings before...
Yeah, I think we should. I think we should go. No, because that's a lot more pre-drinking.
Well, that's what I mean. So if we come in with a bit of a buzz, you know, there might be some screaming. I don't know. I might even bring my old Vince jersey and throw it onto the floor. You know what I mean?
Yeah. As a sign of respect or?
You know, he can take it how he wants. I don't even know what it's a sign of. But yeah, I'll just pick you. Here's the jersey retirement from me, too.
Just does not have a handle on his emotions. Threw the jersey. Did not make it anywhere near the court.
He just goes two rows up.
Yeah. Some child got it in the 300s, but...
Kicks the shit out of me. Ah, God damn it.
I think it's going to really depend on how many kids are sitting around us, how belligerent we'll be, to be honest.
Yeah. That's generally a factor. We got to remain respectful, for sure. But we'll see. I'm very curious as to how the whole thing's going to go down, but...
We're going to get kicked out the arena, get banned, lose our season tickets. You know Vince what? Screws you again, buddy.
It's fine. Oh, for the Lakers game, what's going to go down there? You think anything? By the way, the Lakers have looked freaking great.
JJ Redick, man. I'm actually, this is going to sound crazy, super pumped to see that guy on the sideline coaching.
Me too, man. Yeah. I'm a big fan of that guy. Like
me too.
And same with, we're talking about last week, like we're big fans of Bronny playing with his dad. Like, I don't know why everyone's got to be so negative, you know? JJ Redick is a freaking mad scientist when it comes to basketball. Anyone that's listened to his podcast knows that.
Yeah.
And then LeBron James is playing with his goddamn son. That's incredible, you know?
Yeah. So, hey, man, the world is fucked. Enjoy things, for God's sakes. There's not a lot left.
There really isn't. The few moments of joy we've got, you got to embrace. So,
yeah, if I enjoy JJ Redick drawing up weird plays, let me enjoy it. All right. Is he the first head coach with a full sleeve tattoo?
He's got to be. Yeah, I think he's got to be.
But yeah, Ime Udoka's got a tattooed dick or something weird, something fucking freaky. He's got a Prince Albert piercing on his cock.
Yeah, someone like Lenny Wilkins or like some quiet, polite person where you're just like, oh, he never just showed his sleeves. JJ Redick versus Darko. Who do you got in that chess match?
Does Darko know he's playing chess?
No, he's playing Connect Four.
Yeah,
for some reason.
But he's really fired up though about it, man.
His whole playbook is just different pizza deals.
Yeah.
Amazing.
He accidentally knocks the Connect Four pieces open. We're gonna start over. It's okay. You know what? It's about the time we spent here together building memories.
He was quoted after the Denver game as saying he doesn't believe in moral victories. I was like, really, Darko? Because that seemed to be your entire game plan last year. But
brother, you better believe in those moral ones, because the ones regarding points aren't gonna be too.
Do you think
aren't gonna happen too often?
No, there's no. Do you think upper like Bobby and Masai pulled him aside and were like, hey, man. Don't promise any meals this year. You know, like, let's just focus on the basketball as opposed to the incentives.
Yeah, no, he's probably still doing it. He just makes them sign NDAs. Don't leak this to the media, okay? Fucking don't embarrass me.
Yeah. And then once again, the Denver Nuggets, but this time at the Mile High City, is that what it's called?
I think so.
In Denver is what I was trying to think of a fancy way of saying. On Monday. So, Charlotte, we're going to win. Lakers, I think JJ tops Darko on that one. Sacramento, let's kick the shit out of them, you know?
Yeah, I want to beat DeMar DeRozan every time, every single goddamn time.
And then Denver, we're going to get our vengeance. So, looks like a 2-2 week to me.
I'm I'm all aboard, buddy. Let's do it. Did you see, speaking of JJ Redick, did you see this very hilarious thing happening on Twitter where they're talking about who's the biggest psycho? Is it JJ Redick or Joe Mazzulla?
No, I didn't see that.
And people are basically like, JJ Redick's a basketball psycho. Joe Mazzulla is like a real life actual psychopath.
Okay.
And that has nothing to do with basketball. He is a maniac.
Really?
Yeah.
I could see that because he is very quiet for the most part.
Yeah.
I saw a thing today where he said he wanted to bring fighting back into the NBA.
This is... yes.
You know?
Buddy, I'm all in on Joe Mazzulla.
It's pretty cool.
That's great.
I do like his style. You're
yeah.
Right.
Well, he's got the best team in the league, so you can say whatever the hell you want.
It's a really good point. When they were preseason overseas, they asked... in the UK, they asked if he met the royal family. And he's like, ooh, Jesus... Mary and Joseph.
Like, that's phenomenal answer.
He's like, that's the only royal family I know.
It's hell like, yeah, dude.
Joe fucking Mazzulla. Let's go. Yeah.
That's incredible, buddy.
Yeah. So
they also asked him about how does it feel like everyone's hunting the Celtics? And he's like, we're a predator. We do the hunting. Like, this guy's wicked.
Thing three.
So Kyle Lowry was in town. Of course, with the Philadelphia 76ers on Friday. And then, as you'd expect, he was being showered with praise and questions and asked about the Vince jersey retirement. And he said, you know, he said all the right things, as you would expect from the man. And then his jersey retirement came up and he was very humble, as you'd expect from the man. But then the idea of the statue came up. And that, you mentioned this last week, that's the way it has to go. Just get rid of the bitter aftertaste of Vince having the first jersey retired. Kyle Lowry gets the first statue.
Yeah.
What do you think his pose is for the statue? Nick Nurse said it should be him taking a charge.
Yeah, I agree. It's 100%.
Yeah.
Him taking a charge. Oh, yeah. Or like squeezing the basketball after we won.
Oh, yeah.
That one was fire. Might be too cute, though. I don't think you'd like it.
I could see him kind of like dribbling. So I guess the ball is in the up motion in his hand. And then he's just got like he's calling a play with his other hand and looking up.
Pointing.
You know? Yeah.
Yeah. I like that.
Something like that. Regardless, though, let's make sure they source the correct sculptor because Dwayne Wade's statue came out this past weekend and Sweet Mother of God. This is what, man, Twitter has had a couple good days recently. That was the other good thing about the Denver game, too, is Raptors Twitter was, like, rocking. Like, it was everyone having a good time, you know? It was a lot of fun. And that was also kind of coincided with when a lot of the Dwayne Wade statue memes were coming out, which, great, great work, everybody. Yeah. Really enjoyed those.
It's his head. I don't know who that person is. That's not Dwayne Wade.
To the point where, like, there he has a gap in his teeth.
Yeah.
That's never been, I don't think, ever in that man's life, ever.
No, that's...
definitely not since he was in college and playing in the NBA.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, no, once he got that NBA check, he filled that gap in, like Scotty.
Did he? I don't think he ever had a gap to begin with. Like, what the fuck is that?
I don't think he did either. That was heavy hands by the sculptors, I guess.
Did he just, the sculptor knocked it out and he's like, ah, fuck, they won't notice. The question that everyone is asking, and rightfully so, is how the sweet fuck does that get by everybody?
Well, like, I'm Dwayne Wade, I'm sure.
Oh, there's no chance he saw it before.
No, I think he did.
No.
Yeah,
really?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure I read somewhere that he would have to have like been signed off on it. Yeah, it's his face, it's his likeness. Of course he would.
That's crazy. That is crazy.
Yeah, it looks like he's melting.
Yeah, one of the great memes was Han Solo frozen in carbonite.
Yeah, or maybe that's a glimpse into the future. That's old Dwayne Wade right there. That's how he's going to look in 20 years.
20 years, like I was going to say like 70, like that's 120-year-old Dwayne Wade.
Well, I hope he lives that long, Barry. And
amen. If I'm a betting man and I got to pick one player, I'm taking him over Kobe Bryant. I'll tell you that right
Jesus
now.
Jesus Christ, man. Good God.
If we're going to rank players, you better believe number three.
Oh, I thought you meant who's going to live longer.
Oh, well, that too. He's clearly figured that out.
Yeah, I did. Yeah. And a lot of helicopters in Dwayne Wade's life, I'll tell you that much.
Well, I mean, they're not flying in fog if there are. But
yeah.
I'll say that Kobe has the better statue. That's clear.
Yeah, that's...
He won that battle.
Mm-hmm.
You know what? I actually thought he kind of looks, the statue looks a lot like that. I haven't really seen the comparison online. Is the White Walkers from Game of Thrones or Night Walkers? What the fuck are they called? The bad guys in Game of Thrones.
I never watched Game of Thrones.
Have you even tried Sopranos yet?
No. I can't. I'm done. Jesus. If there's that many. I can't. It's too much. It's done. I missed it. It's okay. It's fine. I can't go back.
You're lucky too much. That there are so many episodes.
I mean, sure.
Man, oh man.
I was watching X-Files at the time, I think. Okay. Probably. Hey, I don't know what to tell you. I'm done. Can't go back. Let's talk more about how Dwayne Wade's statue looks like Bokeem Woodbine. Do you know Bokeem Woodbine?
I do not.
Everyone knows Bokeem Woodbine. He's like a character actor in millions of TV shows. Millions.
Oh. Okay. Well, maybe that's his latest role, is the Dwayne Wade statue.
Maybe that is like one of those statues that it's a man. You know what I mean?
Yeah, like the silver guy.
Yeah, that's what it is. That's a real man. That's not a statue. We're just making fun of a weird-looking man.
Is it worse than the Ronaldo bust that came out years ago?
The Ronaldo one is real bad, dude. I don't think it's worse than that.
No? Okay.
No. The Ronaldo one is crazy.
Yeah, I mean... It's on its doorstep though. Like it's close.
It's close. It's not for sure. The Ronaldo one doesn't blow it out the water, but I think it wins a race there.
Yeah.
It looks like a caricature. Like Dwayne Wade just looks like I'm like, who the hell is this?
That was great. Like that was the thing, is when Wade was at the podium and he's like, who is this guy? You know what I mean? I was like, does he know how insane this is? Like he's gotta know.
Yeah.
I can't. That's crazy to me. If he approved that,
well, but they're like, well, it's going to take us 6 months to fix it, and he's like, "Fuck, Pat Riley is going to snap."
I'd pass. I'd be like, "That's cool."
Yeah.
Speaking of which, Pat Riley said they're contemplating doing a Udon statue, Udonis Haslam, which I'm like, fucking now there's a piece of heat culture I can get on board with.
Yeah, I should put up a Udonis Haslam statue. Why the hell not?
Totally.
You gonna put a LeBron one up?
Yeah, I think they will. Don't you?
Yeah. If you're gonna get a goddamn Udonis Haslam, I think LeBron Udon's was like, more.
He's Mr. Florida though, man, because he went to. Did he go to Central? He went to University in Florida. Where the fuck did he play? Central Florida. Let's Google that quick. And he grew up in Florida, obviously did his whole career.
He's Florida man, yeah. Yeah. I hope they get the same people to make it, though.
The fact also that the guy went to, they held a press conference after, like, just pure balls.
Damage control, baby.
Yeah, he went to University of Florida in Gainesville. So he's, listen, man, this guy's just dripping of Florida goodness. Well, looking forward to the Kyle Lowry statue when it happens, and there's no way they can fuck it up.
Oh, there's a way.
I don't know. I also just think that now, like, the bar has been, this has to be a lesson learned or something.
Thing four.
So many great things coming out with the 30-year celebration, and the good people at Coors Light are releasing three 30-year anniversary cans. They look pretty cool. One is black with the logo, the 30-year logo. One is purple with those lightning stripes that were on the original jerseys. And one is black and red in honor of the chevrons. Listen, I'm the kind of idiot at this point in my life that'll buy a case of beer because they've got Toronto Raptors on the cans.
So, I mean, if we're buying beer, which we will be, I'm firing up the Raptors one.
Well played, Coors Light. You got me.
Yeah. Now, does a Raptor change color? Like, you know how they got the blue mountains? Something's got to change color.
Wow. Wow. That's a great idea.
Yeah.
That's a really good idea. I've become, as I get older, more of a Coors Light and just light beer in general person. So they're really nailing my target demo with this promotion.
Well, I think I agree. I'm a big light beer guy myself. It's because you can drink 10,000 of them and still feel fine.
It's true. My tolerance, or it's not even tolerance. It's like I get fuller quicker. I just can't drink nearly what I could even like 5 years ago.
Yeah.
You know, it's really taking a hit. I don't know if it was the pandemic. I don't know if it's the vax. I don't know what's going on, but my beer drinking skills they've diminished significantly.
Oh, it's mine have significantly improved since the pandemic.
No, you're still in your prime by far. I have seen you you're still going toe to toe with the best of them.
Yeah.
You're even taking out legends like Monty Scott. So
just have taken them out a few times.
Yeah. No, you're on your game. Absolutely. I will say I'm a big Corona guy now though.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Those go down pretty easy. Not too bad of a hangover.
No.
And, you know, makes you feel like you're on the beach sometimes.
Lower alcohol content in that, too. And actually might be similar to Coors Light, is it? Is it a 4?
You know what I am not a fan of are IPAs.
No. What am I, a lumberjack? What too the hell heavy. Am I drinking that for? Yeah. No, it's gross.
I've got friends that swear by them. And I'm just like, dude, that's like a meal. That's like just below a Guinness to me. Yeah. You know?
Well, some of them are like 8% alcohol. And listen, you know what? I'm not going to lie to you. I don't like them, but that's not a bad way to start your night.
That's a good way to form a base.
Yeah.
For sure. Would you ever collect these type of things? Like a beer can?
So I was gonna ask you the same thing. If I think if it wasn't beer, I'd be able to keep it. But just having beer there, I'm like, I'm going to drink that at some point.
Ah. I have a bunch of old Coke cans from 92 when the Jays won the World Series.
That's pretty dope.
Yeah.
Yeah, I can keep them with Coke cans, but you put beer in there, I'm going to be hammered and crack that open. I'll do the old wet paper towel in the freezer trick, Barry.
What's that?
Oh, you know, you go to the store, you get some beer, you forget to put it in the fridge. Now you're thirsty. You want a nice cold beer. You wet a paper towel, you wrap it around the can, fire that into the freezer. 10 minutes, comes out ice cold, buddy.
Really?
Oh, yeah. Oh, that's
I can't believe I've never heard this. That's such a good idea.
Well, this is the most alcoholic shit I've ever talked about in my life, but it works. I can confirm.
Yeah, if you took anything as seriously as you did that, you'd be a millionaire at this point. But
you'd be the goddamn prime minister.
That's a really good trick. I didn't know about that.
Yeah. Not only for beer, anything else you would drink works for that too.
Milk?
Yeah. Just fire a milk in there.
Sure.
Nice chocolate milk.
I haven't drank milk in years.
I haven't had chocolate milk in a while.
Even chocolate milk, man, at this point, I don't know if it's just getting old. It just disgusts me. I'm like, this is so such a gross concept.
It's pretty good, man. Do you eat cheese?
I do.
Well, I don't know what your problem is.
I'm a hypocrite. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Hey, mister, thing 5.
I'm not sure if I'm just starting to notice this or maybe it's new, but I'm pretty sure that I'm just starting to notice it. But the Raptors have been very supportive of former players on their birthdays on social media.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of posts going out to past Toronto Raptors on their birthdays. One that was celebrated within this past week was former first overall pick Andrea Bargnani. And now that you mentioned this before we started recording, I do remember that we talked about this like a couple years ago. But the man's Instagram profile is wild because there's no mention of basketball player.
Yeah.
At all.
Well, we talked about that when you played here. First of all, that was your guy longer than anyone. You believe you were the last guy on that fucking ship for sure.
Dude, he was 7-1 and could shoot threes.
Yeah.
I was like, you can't defend that. And then, turns out he can. So.
Yeah. Well, turns out he defended himself a lot of times because he does not like basketball. And that is very clear. The man made millions of dollars and it's not even in his Instagram profile. I did one TV taping and that shit is the first thing that it says in my.
A Exactly. So this is what it is up to date as of now. This is what he's got going on in his Instagram bio. And it's there's a lot of trades going on here. None of them involve basketball. He's got DJ first and foremost.
Mm-hmm. You know he's good at that.
If there's a way we could hire Andrea Bargnani to DJ an event, I feel like that will lose a ton of money. But
yeah, buddy, get him the next Comedy Records basketball game.
That's a great point.
Fire.
Might be available. So DJ is off the top. Influencer is number two. Okay. Blogger. People still blog?
I don't. Vlog, maybe. Maybe he's got a YouTube channel that we don't know about.
Okay. Well, blogging is the number three profession. Lifestyle advisor. You need some advice on your lifestyle? You're going to want to hit up Andrea Bargnani. Number five, mental coach. Listen, if the man had a weakness when he played, pretty sure it was in the mental aspect.
Well, I like that he realized his weakness and he tried to make it a strength. Good.
Or maybe he's just like, you see what I do? Don't do that.
Yeah.
That's how he coaches.
His whole thing is just, it is what it is, man.
PR guru.
Okay. Good God, man.
PR, like, so he does... you know what? Let's just move on. Trendsetter. He's a trendsetter.
Hell yeah, he is.
Trendsetter. Film producer.
Oh my God.
100% got to look up this man's IMDb.
Yeah.
Got to be some bangers in that. Model.
Okay.
Yeah.
For like I mean, big and tall store? Absolutely.
He's a pretty handsome man, too. You know?
Yeah, he's okay. He's no Ochai Agbaji, I'll tell you that much. But.
Well, let's... Helicopter pilot.
He killed that. Kobe.
and survived. This is the one that really got me. The second to last one, astronaut trainee. So there's a chance Andrea Bargnani's going to space, or is he just do that freelance at home?
He just watches YouTube videos. It does seem like all those things are just things that he should have done instead of basketball. I think that's what he's doing.
He's like, I wanted
to do all these things, but I'm just a tall idiot and they made me play basketball and I hated every second of it.
And his final one is stay at home dad.
That's nice. So, I'm not going to make fun of that.
No, that's fine. But just real quick.
We find out he has no kids. So.
No, he stays at home because he's training to go to the moon. Yeah. Fuck's sake. He could be the first man. To land on the moon.
I don't think they would let him go being that tall. I don't think he can be that tall as an astronaut.
You know what? No one's been up there, so don't get me started on that.
Yeah. We know what you did, Stanley Kubrick.
And just real quick, open up his IMDb page. There don't seem to be any production credits. However, he does have an acting credit. He was in Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles Out of the Shadows.
What?
Came out in 2016. So.
What?
Apparently.
Holy shit. Oh, he's also in a Primo Pasta commercial that you might remember. So that's a.
That's a good point. I don't see that as a.
He might be in the union, buddy.
Oh, he may be. Doesn't seem to have a credit for that on here. But man, there were a lot of good actors in this Ninja Turtles movie. There's Megan Fox, Will Arnett. Andrea Bargnani, obviously. Tyler Perry. That looks about it. Brad Garrett. Brad Garrett was a voice of Krang. What?
I assume. Wow, that's an animated one that I did not see, I assume.
Nah, it's real. Like a.
Yeah, yeah. I believe you. I don't know how the hell Andrea Bargnani got in that.
You know what? And I'm looking here. We've got several people listed under the cast but did not see him. So, well, you know. Man, if anyone's ever watched that, you haven't watched that movie, have you?
No, no.
Might have to now.
Yeah, but I cannot believe we just said Andrea Bargnani and Tyler Perry in the same sentence. This is nuts.
This is where the world is right now.
Thing six, many tricks.
Go around the league.
Wait, we going around the league?
What stood out to you this past week around the league? Anything in particular? I would say to me, the Lakers and JJ Redick's coaching has been pretty cool.
Yeah, watching the Lakers not be a disaster was pretty. It's pretty nice to see. I think the Knicks are going to regret getting Kat. That's what I I think I'm right about that. I think Randall's going to do a lot for the Timberwolves.
Hey, he looked great against us.
Yeah. He just looks like he plays harder, man. I don't know. Cat's like, he's too soft. I don't want to be calling gigantic men soft like that, but there's something about him that I don't like watching him play basketball.
I think they'll be okay. I think there's still, what was it? The two nights ago they were playing and he only touched the ball 7 times or something like that. That's, you know, they gotta figure it out still. Opening night though, they looked like a pure disaster.
Yeah.
They were against Boston, obviously, but Joel Embiid, which we touched on last week, but didn't play opening night, which is fucking weird.
Nuts.
Like it's like, dude, how are you load managing the first game of the year? Like, what were you doing prior to this?
It makes no sense.
Which goes back again to that clip of Kevin Garnett talking about 82 games.
What do you think is a good number of games he played?
82 games, man. This is what the fucking job calls for. You're not practicing. You're not even playing a whole fucking... You don't play in the summer. Right. I can see if you playing in the summer, you're on the playground, you went to the Olympics, then it's training camp. Y'all do 30 days of fucking tour days. Okay, that's when you get rest. Man, I don't want to hear this shit, man. I don't want to hear none of this shit. Motherfucker can sit out a back-to-backs. Bro, don't, bro. Hey, listen, we done with that comparison of the era shit. We're going to respect this era and what it does, and that's it.
Pure fire.
Didn't see Andrea Bargnani resting back-to-backs, I'll tell you that much, and he didn't want to be there in the first place.
Goddamn right. Rudy Gay has retired.
That's right. Not this fucking guy.
Fucking Rudy Gay, man!
Gonna miss him, man. He was, big part of the legacy, really helped us by getting traded, and...
I love Rudy Gay, man. Also, a legend on the All Handsome team for quite a few years. He was up there.
Yeah, no, he's an absolute Hall of Famer on the All Handsome team. How do you think he's going to be looked back on?
I started reading a bit of his Player Tribune. Got sidetracked. ADD and so on and so forth. Millennial, blah, blah, blah. And he's like, listen, I know... I wasn't what I was supposed to be. He's like, blamed on an injury. He's blamed on a bunch of things. He's like, I'm not going to be that guy, though.
Okay.
Which is pretty cool. He told a story about Kobe, so you're going to love it. Get to read it.
Fucking Rudy Gay, man.
Finally, some good news. Koloko has been cleared to play, so he'll be joining the Lakers soon.
Yeah, so, nice that it's not on our team, but...
Yeah, that would have been cool.
Yeah.
Nice that the guy's healthy enough to suit up and play in the NBA.
Yeah, you can't... You can't be nothing but happy for the guy. A little bit sour, but I'm happy for him.
Would have really enjoyed him being on the team, yeah. For sure.
Mm-hmm.
But he's out west, so not our problem.
And we got Kelly Olynyk coming back, so we're going to be just fine.
Hey, actually, I wonder if he's going to be back on Friday when the Lakers are here. Maybe gets a nice little ovation.
Oh, that'd be cool. No, I think he's just ramping it up. I don't think he'll be back. I'm pretty sure he's just cleared to like do actual practice and shit now.
Okay. I think that's going to wrap it up. What shows do you have on the... Oh, hey, we've got an announcement. I'll make this so you don't have to feel weird, but congratulations. You were selected as one of the comics to watch at the New York Comedy Festival. It's happening in November.
Pretty pumped.
Now, that's a big deal for those who are not familiar with the comedy industry. And you know what? There's a lot of you.
Yeah.
We're aware, which is fine. Because it's just comedy. It's not important. But it's basically like the, you know what the best way to compare it? It's like the McDonald's All-American game for comedy.
Perfect. Yeah. Hell yeah.
At the New York Festival. And you're selected. You're on the All-American team. Despite being Canadian.
I can't. I'll do my best. It's going to be a fun time. I just want to go to New York, eat some chopped cheese, get hammered. It's going to be a fun time.
It's going to be great, man. So you're doing two shows. That's happening Friday, November 15th at Gotham Comedy Club. At The Stand Comedy Club. And congrats, buddy. It's truly awesome. And it's one of the biggest things to happen to Comedy Records by association. So we'll ride your coattails.
Hell yeah, baby. Right to the top.
Yeah. So we'll have some more stuff to talk about next week that involves the NBA. As well.
Ooh.
For the New York Comedy Festival. But if anyone is looking for a road trip, November 15th, hit up New York City, two shows. It's what, 8 and 10 o'clock?
8 and 10, yeah.
8 and 10 at the Stand. You can check it up. It's listed on your website, nickreynoldson.com, but that's going to be dope. Can't wait for that. Anything else coming up that we should add to that?
Saskatchewan? Regina?
Yeah, that's right. That's right. Yeah, the week prior. This is out. This is life. Okay? So that's happening November 15th, but November 7th and 8th, you'll be in Regina and Saskatoon as part of the K. Trevor and Wilson Friends Tour. So if you're listening out there, hit us up because there are there's tickets available.
You can get some tickets.
Okay. We can, you know what? You don't even got to pay for them.
Email Comedy Records. We'll get you on there.
You message us at Comedy Records if you're in Regina or Saskatoon, want to come to a show November 7th or 8th. We got you. Don't worry about it. Life is good. We're almost 2-2. Team's a lot of fun. Feeling good.
This is going to be the season of almost, and I'm not mad at it. We're almost good, baby. We're almost good.
Let's go Raptors.
Fucking Rudy Gay, man!